Okay, some updates. I think we're in business now with spindle control with the C6 board from CNC4PC and Mach 4. Got some tips from Eric on YouTube about setting up Mach 4. Let's see. Disable. Going to Mach. Okay. I don't need anything. I had motor 6 set up. I just unchecked that. Under axis mapping, don't set anything up under that OB16. Just leave it blank. Under spindle, for the 0 here, you put your minimum and maximum. I got 50 minimum, 4500 max. I put Excel times of 1 second each. Under spindle, max spindle RPM, you put the same thing you have for max up here, so it's 4500. Under step direction, pick none, because I disabled that OB16 thing, so I just put none. You don't need to set those things up. The output signals, you come down to spindle on and spindle forward. I have them both checked. They're both at a Darwin. Spindle on is what I have marked as a C6 step. That's this, what the output pin is for my C6 board. And the same for direction of forward. Settings are the same in Darwin that I had for output signals. I'm using signal 7 as the step pin, so I got it set to port and pin 14 for my C6, and under I'm using signal 8 for my C6 direction pin. It's got port 1, pin 1, that's what I'm using. Make sure you enable them both. Okay, and the tip I got from Daniel on CNC Zone for the M3 is just to remove those macros. This is the backup folder. You go to your Mach 4 hobby folder, you go to your profiles. So backup was my backup. You can see that M3, M4, M4, M5, M5. You just delete those. Mach 4 folder is the one I'm actually using, so you can see I've deleted those files from the Mach 4 macros folder, so that when you start up Mach 4, click enable. That's how you notice the spindle is set at its normal 100. Go into MDI. So I can type in M3S4500. Click cycle start. As you can see, it's running at my max voltage, which is full speed. Put an M5. Cycle start and shuts it off. Now I can put in M3S, say 1800. You can hear it's running a lot slower. The voltage is lower. But now, when I'm using the percentage override, if I take it up to 250%, it takes me up to my max speed. If I go down below 100%, you can hear, it runs a lot slower. Should get a real tack hooked up so you can see it, but see. So now the percentage matches up with what it you call for in the S speed. So if I'm calling for a speed of 1800, I can override it. Look at that, that's an M5. I can start, shuts it off. What I did, had to play with to get that to work out right, was under Diagnosis Darwin was the frequency control. I have it set to 0. And I had to adjust it, played around with it, got it to, right now mine's at 375, so it works out just right, so that when the spindle is set at 100% and I call for M3, say S4500, my max RPM, it runs at, you know, 4500. So that's what you want to do. Leave that at 100 and make your adjustments, because this percentage override will be overriding whatever you happen to call for in your speed setting under M3. And of course the button still works by itself. What it seems to be going by is the last S speed called. That's what it's basing that on. Seems to be anyway. But there we go. It's working now.